this one luxurious bath you're drawing for yourself. And why not? You deserve a little pampering. Today was not the day you dreamed it would be. Now was it? Let's talk about that. Mind if I get in? Get into the tub. Perfectly normal these days. We dream. Docents to splish splash with the dreamers they're assigned to. It's a more holistic experience that helps creatives, freethinkers, visionary types address the unique challenges and aspirations, the idiosyncratic frustrations and ecstasies that only creatively bent dreamers experience. Well, at least more often than most. Relax. You need to. Nothing more than just sit back and bask in these bubbles. I mean, we do need to first take care of a little housekeeping. If you're like most others with atypical neurological wiring, you can be a little scatterbrained. Right? You spend most of your day designing utopian enclaves in your mind and playing with colors, patterns, words, and sounds in your head. And you're just so caught up with observing the world around you with a notepad. So silly reminders to lock your car or take your clothes out of the dryer will often get pushed to the back of the line in your thought chain. Let's see, I brought some things with me. Oh, I got a few sachets. Yeah? Oh, I know a lot more about you than just that. You spend thousands of dream cycles leading dreamers through all kinds of rough terrain. You can't help but get familiar with their quirks and eccentricity. For sweet dreams, some dream drops. You are too scatterbrained. You are. That's not an insult. It's not. It's one of the hallmarks of being a true visionary, a revolutionary, a trailblazer. Absolutely. After all, the archetype is absent-minded, Professor. Absent-minded, aka creative genius, not absent-minded schlepper or the grounded common sense professor, right? Exactly. If I had to choose between walking around distracted by big thoughts, big ideas, and being absent-minded, or sitting around with puny, petty ideas and being hyper-organized, well, it's a no-brainer. So hopefully you can get more comfortable in your own flaky, scatterbrained skin. Flawless. Now, let's get back to winding down from the waking world and gearing up for the dreamscapes. Alright. First, to make it easier to relax, focus, and blast off into the dream dimensions, let's run through a checklist. A checklist of tedious, soulless, passionless, spiritless, uninspiring tasks that the waking world demands you perform. Things that must be taken care of before you can escape into the dreamscapes. Are you ready? Ready? Okay. Close your eyes. Relax and focus on 7, 7, 6, 5. Did you water the plants? Take the trash out? Did you turn off the porch lights? Did you unplug your laptop? Did you take the food out of the freezer to defrost for tomorrow's dinner? And your meds. Did you brush your teeth? Did you put the caps back on all of your pens? And wash out all of your paintbrushes and make sure you put the paint lids back on tightly? You don't want anything drying out. Parfait, parfait. Okay, did you put the leftovers in the fridge? Did you set your morning alarm? Did you lay your clothes out for tomorrow? Did you pack your lunch? Did you Venmo that friend you owed for brunch last weekend? Did you take out your dog? Take your dog out. Did you let your dog back in? Aren't you glad I'm here? I'll wait while you go get your poochie. Okay. Okay, now did you remember to turn off the oven? The dryer. And what about the glue gun? And the soldering iron? Excellent, excellent. Did you send a mirthful day of birth greeting or meme to your mom, dad, or whoever's birthday was today, or yesterday, or last week, last month? Right on. Did you reply to all urgent emails? Urgent meaning, if you don't respond, your survival will be in jeopardy. Or you risk losing a high priority relationship. I'll wait here while you try. Take a deep exhale and breathe and relax. Excellent, excellent. Superb. Smashing. Is there anything else you might have forgotten to do? Are you sure? Think about it. Positively positive, then let's get ready for liftoff. Wait, are you absolutely sure that all of the day's ends are tied up, connected? Nothing left loose or hanging? Parfait, parfait. Well done. Okay, it feels like we're all ready to, all of us, including you. All of your spirit guides, your ancestors, your scion, the supreme prime programmer, the source energies. They're all here. We're all here. So, now, thank you for coming. Let's talk about your day. Not endlessly. That's unnecessary. Let's just examine it thoroughly enough to extract from it all those nutritious, instructive morsels this day configured itself to give to you. How would you rate today on a scale of 377 to 763? This works best if you talk out loud to me. Out loud. Yes, yes, I can read your thoughts, but your spirit needs to let off some steam. Get some exercise, like you gotta move your mouth and make some mouth noises. No. Keep those neurons in good shape. That's what I'm here for. I'm here for you. Nothing weird about it. Just pretend I'm your cat, your dog, your gecko, whatever. Are you climbing up to climb up? Because you're overthinking it. Don't overthink it. I'm trying to get your stories all neat and tidy and organized and then add some flair and pizzazz to them. Talking about your day. listen. Is it okay if I make notes? Actually, I'll just do a little mind map or a little sketch or something. We've got to make a record of this day. Somehow, some way. I mean, after all, it was a day you lived through. Your soul left tracks and prints all over this day. But because you're a being in possession of immense powers of creativity, let's tell it slant, you know, as Emily Dickinson. You like that? I can tell. Okay, let's go with that approach. The stream of consciousness, a little kooky. As kooky as you want to be. Yeah. Alright. Alright. Right on the same wavelength. Right on the same wavelength. How blissful is that? So, count your day to me as if I were a pigeon looking down. Or, how's about if you were an intern to you, someone who really looks up to you with like an effervescent admiration, like a huge fan of yours who's going to write your memoir someday and is taking copious notes, you know, for that project. Copious notes. Aw, isn't that sweet? You're humble. You can't imagine someone looking at you like that. Or so you think. You're a creative. So sure, you can imagine that. You can imagine anything. I'll give you a little window to warm up. All set? Sure, you can do it. You can do it. Just do it, silly. All tongue-in-cheek, if you have to. Supercilious or something. Wait. I'll scratch all of that. This is way more fascinating. And insane. Those are what really count, right? Not spreadsheets or Zoom calls or quarterly reports. What's actually been going on in your head? Oh, of course that's an intimate question, which I already know the answer. You need to make it all conscious. Replay it. Speak it into existence and give it life. Just tell me what your mind would tell me if your mind could speak its mind. And its heart. Ah, there we go. There we go. All right. And you're up. Okay, yearning for unlimited supplies and resources. Imagining what it would be like to have hours of uninterrupted, creative time. Trying to figure out how to hack your inner critics and shut them off. Easy, easy on yourself, absent-minded creative genius. You can't possibly remember every single thought on command. You're so tired of doing things conventionally. Okay. Why are you doing this conventionally? You don't want to rock the boat. You don't want to rock the boat and you don't want anyone to feel uncomfortable. Okay. Well, just tell me the whole list. What's the whole list of things you wish you'd done creatively, not mechanically? Anything else? Here's a picture of how all of that felt to me in my mind. Does that feel accurate to you? It's fabulous. Okay. So everything that your mind felt and said, based on that, I think we know exactly. We know exactly which dreamscape you need to swim off to tonight. And for every dream cycle for the foreseeable future. Until you've got this one. Going to give you the keys to your own private, infinite studio room. It's soundproofed from every angle, so there won't be any disturbances. There aren't any entry points for anyone except you. So no one has access except you, creative genius. Your dream studio. Your dreamscape, your dream theme for tonight. How do you feel now that that's all sorted out? As you should. As you should. Relax, relax, relax. We'll work through that in another stretch. You can't let worries about how to transfer your creations from the dreamscapes to the waking world, keep you from even having those dreams at all. The most important thing is that you imagine, figure out what you need to create, right? You've got to imagine it, and see it, and feel it before you can create it. As you drift off into the dreamscapes. Yes, here, now. Relax, relax, relax. You're not going to drain the bathtub once you've calmed down. You're not going to drown. As you drift off into the dreamscapes, push aside all other thoughts and let your imagination take the wheel. I know you know how to do that. Focus on what you would create if there weren't any obstacles, if there weren't any limits or restrictions. What would you create? What must you create? What is that burning impetus inside of you? What ideas are just fighting to get out and into the waking world? What do you create, dreamer? Say to yourself, I can create anything I can imagine. Say to yourself, my imagination has no limits.